Video to hi guys, welcome to a new video. Today we're gonna show you how the car door mechanism work, and if it doesn't work, what happens. So this is the way it works. So you have this guy here. This is the thing which you press, like when you pull up this, it pulls the wire and the wire goes like, so when it goes like that, it gives access to, you can see there. Wonder if you can see well. Let me put on the light for you. I'm bringing the light on. I think the light is on now. Okay. So now you can see well there. When I pull this, you can see that moves. So I had a problem where by this car locked itself and it could not open. So the reason why is, you see that wire which goes up with the yellow thing, and that teeth, the wire went behind the teeth. So the reason why, somebody who installed this, he did not install it well. So he put that wire this side. So whereby it was conflicting, whenever someone could lock with the key, that wire which goes up, you can see it goes to the lock. That's the wire, when you turn the key, it pushes that mechanism down or up. So it went up. So whenever you could lock with the key, it could go behind that. So now what we're playing here. So when I say, if I press this, you can see nothing happens. I'm gonna bring the key and I show you. So I'm gonna use the key here and I switch on. You can see when I do the key, that goes up, that goes down, that goes up, that goes down, that goes up, that goes down. Okay, you can see that. That's simple. So when you use the key, there shouldn't be any conflicts. So before, when I could use the key, those two wires were going what, in a different direction, you can see. So now I change that lock, you can see the lock. See the lock, yeah. This lock, you can see the one which push up and down, up and down. So okay, up and down, you can see that lock is the one for the key. And also there's a manual one, which is this, you push, is the same thing, but here you use the key, there you don't use the key. So now I managed to separate it, so that teeth, it has a different thing with it, so there is no more conflict again. So that's the way the mechanism work. So if you have a problem whereby the car doesn't open or it doesn't close, so this is the thing to look into. You have to make sure those wires do not conflict. So now we're working on a Chevy. You might find yours is different, but this is the place where you have to come. You have to find each and everything should be separate from another one. You understand? So you don't have to get any stress on that. So we're done with that and everything is fine. So, but now we have to put a screw there. You can see there's a screw there. And so there's another screw up here. So it fell. I can't get it. I'm going to put in that one. Then you see that everything is going to be fine. You can do this by yourself. I'm gonna show you, I'm sorry that I didn't show you how to open. I'm gonna show you how to close, but it's the same thing. If you know how to close, you know how to open. So I need a 10 spanner, which is this. I'm gonna use, and plus this. So I'm sure 100% my stuff is working. So I'm gonna put in that screw. Let's see, yeah, I guess. Let's see the screw there. It's something simple to do, but now some people makes it a little bit difficult and they mess up with your car. So I'm gonna do this. I use this spanner. Okay. Don't squeeze it a lot because you might make a mistake and you want to open again. So, when I close it, it's locked, that's why it doesn't open. You can see. So those things, they work together. Like if I lock, I've locked, cannot open. So if I open, it's gonna open. So it's the same as this, whereby if you lock, it will lock. If you don't, if you unlock, it's the same. So, but inside here, you just access using, but outside you're using the what? The key. So that's the only difference there. So opening this mechanism is connected to the same mechanism which is being used here. You can see here is the same. So when you do like this, there's a wire which pulls up and also gives the car access to open. You understand? So once you're done with that, you have to know that these are the same. Sometimes you find the car does not open inside and opens outside. You can check here. You might find that this wire is broken. There's no more touching here. If it's that the case, you have to find, buy new of this. You replace it. Once you replace it, it's gonna work. Also, at the same time, outside there, you might find that the wire, if the car doesn't open outside, there is a wire. I'm gonna try to see if you can see. When you pull, you can see that wire. See this wire that which shakes, that touches to the plastic which gives access to the which you press. Let me show you. That wire is connected to this. Whenever I pull this, that wire goes up or down. Understand? So when it goes up, it opens the door. So once you cannot open from outside, just know everything is connected to what? To that. So which means you have to check that. You can see where it is. So you have to check to that. If that wire doesn't work anymore, so it simply means you can see what it does. So it's connected to the plastic which opens the door. You can see up there to the mechanism. You can see, you see it. I'm pulling the door outside. You can see that is dancing up, dancing down, dancing up, dancing down. So what you do, you come in here, you press that thing outside the door. If you don't see any dancing, just know that that wire might be out, which means that it might be not connected. So if it's not connected, find a way to take out that plastic and see how to reconnect that. Once you learn how to reconnect that, everything's gonna be fine and your door's gonna open out or inside. You get me? So that's as simple as ABC. Don't get scared of breaking things. You break them, you fix them, or you buy something new, then you learn how to do this. I've learned this by myself just couple of days ago, and the guy who installed it didn't install it well, which helped me to learn more. So I took it out, I went myself and come and opened my car. I saw how it works, I fixed it myself. You can see now it can open and close. So the only thing which is remaining is to just to cover up everything. I'm gonna put back this plastic. You can see I'm gonna hook in up this back. You get me? I'm gonna connect back this. Understand, this is for the power, what they call the what, the, we call them the power, what, power window, electric window. So this is the thing for the electric window. You understand? So I'm gonna connect that myself and the car is gonna be better. It's gonna be 100% fine because I'm done with that, so I don't need anything anyway. So there was a screw, there is a screw which fell in there, which I cannot get. That's impossible for me to do because there's no way I can do this. So I can also get something like a 10 screw which I can ask from somewhere, then I put it up there, which is not something easy to do. So now guys, I'm gonna conclude the video, and I put, if you have any information you need or anything you need to ask, please you can ask in the comment box below. I'm gonna put back this, and that's one of the parts I want you to see. So before you do anything, you get your stuff, this, the door panel. How does it look like? It looks like this. So you start from up. You can see you're gonna start from up and make sure that is in. Okay, once that is in, you press it against that side a lot to the wall that side. Then you see, you might have a problem. You have to take this first. This is something you have to take first. I'm gonna give you what you're gonna take first. There are things you have to take out first. One thing you have to do, you have to connect this, reconnect this first before anything happens. You have to reconnect. Okay? You have to reconnect this first. Okay. It's easy to connect, but a bit challenging. I'm gonna do it for you guys. Guys, before you put in back, you make sure this goes out here. So once it goes out here, you put this up, and I'm using one hand to do everything. Okay, and you push in this locker. See, you can see the rubber is getting out. I have to make sure it's in properly before I do anything else. You push it in, so you can see this is fine. This is not fine. So these two, you see, it has these two hooks. You see these two hooks, they hook up in there. So you have to make sure they hook up in there. You see the two hooks here. You can see the hooks, these hooks. I believe you can see them, those two hooks. They hook up somewhere here. So I'm taking out the plastic so that it can fit. Okay. Okay, once they hit, you slide it, then it's gonna go in. So there's something else you have, so you have to put, which is this. So that has some hooks. Once you do that, you are fine to go. And then you start hitting, hit a bit, hit. There are clips here. Once you hit it, it's gonna be fine. So once everything is fine, you start screwing in stuff. One of the screws I would prefer to start with is gonna be this, cause I forgot it last time. And it's so crucial. You cannot forget this. Okay, once you do that, you press that in. You can see, once that is done, you're fine. You can open and close. Okay, once that is gone, there's this one also. You can see that it goes in there. You cannot put in with the machine here. That can only go in somewhere, something else. So I'm gonna use that for that. And I'm using this for that. Okay. Okay. I need another one here. Something we don't have to compromise. You have to put each and every screw in. It fell down. Okay. So you have to. Falling, keep on falling. That's why you need, sometimes a simple screwdriver is better than these automated stuff. It's in. Okay, there are a couple of them to go. I'm gonna give you more. Okay, there is one here at the bottom. Okay. One at the bottom, I put it here. There are two. Anyway, I'm gonna put one first. Okay, I'm done with that. In the process, I'm gonna put also this. Okay. Okay, I'm done with that. Okay, I've remained with one only, so it's gonna need a screwdriver. Okay. Okay, then we're gonna do that ourselves. We roll in this. Okay, guys, I think we're done. Did it ourselves. No help with of a mechanic or whoever. We're gonna lock. We open. You lock. You open. You lock. You open. This door is not working, guys. Thanks for watching, guys. See you in the next video. If you want anything about to do the car doors and stuff, tell us, guys, in the comment box below. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.